Alright then. I didn't think it could be done either. I had big plans to make a video about Inception, but here we are. Inception was my favorite film for the longest time. After seeing it for the first time, I was completely and utterly stunned. And I continued to study the film over the next few years with half a dozen viewings. But I never really wanted to admit it. I started to realize it wasn't as perfect as I originally thought. Or at least it wasn't my favorite movie. So whenever I told people that this is my new favorite film, everyone reacted a little more than I expected.
My favorite movie is La La Land!
They asked, what do I see in it? What was so different about this time than the first time? And all I could bring myself to say is, wait for the video. So the real question has to be asked, how can I make a video convincing the entirety of the internet that this is my favorite film? And I don't even know if it's possible. But I guess it wouldn't hurt to give it a shot. So I'm not the biggest music aficionado or anything, I'm more of a film and visuals guy, but the score in this film is undeniably brilliant. Not just because it's a brilliantly composed soundtrack, but also how the music is used in the film. The music exists in universe, or as others would call it, diegetic music. Music that not only we are listening to, but our characters on screen we see are listening to it as well, which creates an even more immersing experience because we have the same feelings as the characters in that moment. The way how not only songs are used to tell a story, but show the themes of hope and dreams. They show the reality of life isn't what we always believe it to be, or rather want it to be. Another Day of Sun, the song that the film opens with, shows the complex nature of how a person would perceive life to be. Well, yes, in fact, it is another day of sun around them, but presumably is nothing like that inside them. The next song, Someone in the Crowd, carries the same theme of Hollywood glamour. How truly beautiful the colors are on the outside, but how soulless and desaturated it is on the inside. Mia starts to realize the true nature of Hollywood in this scene, as she's alone observing the people around her. Why they are there and she isn't. How awful it is that she is talented but isn't in the business to sleep with someone for a part. This is communicated not just from the various film techniques, but the music. It goes from loud and exciting to quiet and depressing when certain thoughts come into Mia's head, but is overwhelmed again and sends both the visuals and the music back into something distracting so we can't see what the true nature of the scene is anymore, just as our protagonist feels. I used to laugh at this scene when I watched it for the first time, but on my repeat viewing, I listen to the story the music is telling me, and I find that this is one of the most interesting and introspective moments in the film. But the music in this film isn't just interesting and fun. Mia and Sebastian's theme is this film in a nutshell. It summarizes both Mia's desire to be a Hollywood actress and Sebastian's love for jazz in just 7 notes. This is the reason why you feel the connection in this scene. The sorrow of what could have been, the happiness of where they are now, the love that they share for one another, the journey that they both appreciate and acknowledge. This song, yet so simple, packs so much emotion and story into it, bringing us to the epilogue between Mia and Sebastian, the epilogue to both the relationship and the music that plays throughout this scene, summarizing every event in such a cohesive way, incorporating every element of each song prior to build up to this final cathartic moment. A moment that just doesn't sum up the message of this movie, but the movie as a whole. And even though I can't tell you the difference between 4-4 and 6-8 tempos, I can still appreciate what this music does in this film. Tells us a story. A story that may seem simple on the outside, but all the more complex on the inside. And that is why the music in La La Land is my favorite. Probably the single most beautiful film I've seen. The frame is just filled with so much. The color in this film isn't just to make every shot dazzling to the eye, but tell a story. The cinematography isn't just there to make me gush at how much thought was put into every shot, but tell a story. The direction isn't there just to give each scene incredible pacing, but yes, tell a story. Every bit of the word visual is used in service of the story. Alright, so let's just kill ourselves right off the bat and start with cinematography, because holy sh! Every shot in this film is something beautiful to look at. every shot has a purpose. I already explained how the slow walking scene of Mia is musically brilliant, but another is how the camera is used in swift, slow motions to communicate what Mia is feeling. The opening scene displays the wonder and excitement through the music and cinematography. The usage of a fake wonder gives the feeling of fluidity, as one would imagine and dream about in Hollywood. Also, yeah, it's just cool. Then to transfer us to Sebastian's perspective of him rewinding the tape over and over to give that sense that Hollywood just isn't perfect, like the musical number told us not even 20 seconds ago. And again, another transfer, this time to Mia's perspective, showing us the same instance as Sebastian, therefore tying their stories together just 6 minutes into the film. And this is all due to the visuals with the cinematography. Then in the next scene, it shows us examples of homages it creates for itself. One where Mia is behind the counter taking the order, and the next is in front giving the order. The same shot, but the places of the actors are different, therefore showing the progression of the character throughout the movie. In fact, it actually does this many times throughout the film, even in some cases recreating a frame shot for shot. My favorite instance of where this technique is used is when Mia is driving her car. All three of these scenes have the same shot, but have three different meanings. The first one is to show the anticipation of going to the theater with Sebastian for research. Next is the exact same shot with one thing changed. The sign on the board indicating that that part of their relationship has passed, and are going on a whole new one. Finally, the third shot, which is the same, but the background and direction are changed. The first two scenes flow together, because Mia is feeling the same way about her dreams and aspirations. But when no one shows up to her play, and it's thought to be below average, she stops chasing her dream, therefore going in the opposite direction she was initially going. This is what I want more of. A film that tells a complete story with just the placement of the camera. I just gave some examples of what I love, but literally, every frame of this film is beautiful. The way this scene uses silhouette lighting to make our protagonist have a sense of connection. The way it uses long take wonders to draw our attention to what's happening with the actors. The way handheld camera movements are used when necessary. The way when the camera is whipped back and forth. Seriously, are you telling me you are too good for this? It hurts me that I never truly appreciated how beautiful the cinematography is. Keeping the style that Chazelle is used to, but still expanding the frame into things like this and this. I will never stop watching this film for me to appreciate the time, the effort, the passion that went into something that I believe is so close to perfection for my eyes. But we all know the visuals in this film couldn't be perfect without another important thing. Color is something that I never really noticed until La La Land. Many films go with whatever looks nice. And granted, I love Blade Runner 2049's color palette as much as the next guy, but the reason why this film goes above and beyond is it tells us, well, you know. The colors in this film show us the state of characters. I can see you're not convinced, so let me show you. Mia and Sebastian are shown in multiple states of their relationship, just through the usage of color. The pool party scene where Sebastian performs a cover of Iran shows us how both are just not on the same page, because their colors are completely different. And this is not just due to how they look, but what they represent.
Like McDonald's?
No! Yellow represents happiness, positivity, clarity, optimism, and enlightenment, while red represents war, danger, strength, power, and determination, which explains not just where their relationship is, but where they are as an individual. Cut to after the party, and we start to see some more similarities between them. Until this point, all their interactions have been different colors, besides this one. Which in this scene, both are actually on the same page, but Sebastian refuses to notice it. Now we see that Sebastian has lost his brown pants, which I will add that I'm not sad about. And Mia has gained a red bag.
I wonder if that could have had to do with Sebastian in the last scene.
The next day, we see even more similarities between them, where both are wearing white shirts, and then the scene after that... You know what? You guys get the picture. Where we really start to see another change of direction is where Sebastian starts working with his band, who is now surrounded by colors. Similar to how Mia was at the beginning, as their roles have switched. And as I said before, this is all in service of the story. So finally, when we fast forward 24 minutes later into the movie, we have this incredible, breathtaking montage where both get their dance once again. But one thing that is missing in this scene, the color. Their first dance is filled with the bright, vibrant sky, showing their connection to one another. But their last dance, while beautiful, has no color because neither chose to chase their dreams. And even though they are connected through what they are wearing, it's devoid without love, without passion. All of this culminates together in the last scene, with both being lit blue, blue being the constant color for the relationship, blue meaning trust, loyalty, wisdom, confidence, intelligence, faith, symbolizing the relationship as a whole, showing that yes, they aren't together, but it's okay because they will still love each other for as long as they live, because they are connected through the visuals. And that is why the visuals in La La Land are my favorite. A vision. A man with an idea that he transform into a vision, then transform that vision into a reality. My man, my bae, Damien freaking Chazelle. He brings every scene from his script to life. He shows how the word musical doesn't have to be limited to the word and can be so much more. He takes ideas out of classic directors' playbooks and makes it his own. Photograph the Photograph is an idea constructed by Stanley Kubrick and is used with mirrors in this film, a way of showing characters reflecting on who they are and is only used in musical numbers. Whenever he changes perspectives through camera motions, that scene now plays differently to how it did before. Like when Sebastian is playing the piano in the restaurant. One second he's playing this, then to transfer onto his left side and starts playing with purpose and passion. Not just playing whatever he's told, but what he truly wants to. This is why I love this movie. Damien collects so many different ideas into one 2-hour and 8-minute masterpiece. Whenever I pay attention to the directing in this film, I get so inspired, but then so depressed because I know I'll never be able to make something like this. But still, I love watching it because then I can watch not just to get discouraged, but to learn. Learn to achieve something inventive like this film is. Because we all know that is what is going to save film. To not let it get stale or boring, but interesting and fun. But you know what else is interesting and fun? The editing. Damien Chazelle, while not fully in charge of the editing, definitely has a hand in how the way this film comes together. Him and Tom Cross have worked on every big project he's done, and it shows. Every film was so precisely edited, edited with such care and thought. Do you know why Whiplash is so tense? Because the editing gives us that brisk, fast pace to it all. The way how this film is edited, however, is to share screen time with both our protagonists and is absolute perfection. How in the long take scenes, it cuts so smoothly, you probably didn't even notice the first time around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. The editing is often an overlooked variable in films. Take the scene where Sebastian is getting photographed by the band. Things seem to be alright until the music cuts off, and it's almost treated as disturbing that he's missing Mia's play. How when he starts to play his and Mia's theme, it almost feels like a breath of fresh air from the silence. Every cut has a purpose with the story it's trying to tell, which some movies seem to miss. I know I've already taken a jab at Bohemian Rhapsody, but watching this scene, I have no clue what I'm supposed to feel because it just cuts too fast. While instead in La La Land, the shot lingers on a person, showing their emotions and how they feel. And instead, we just get...
I admire your enthusiasm. If it goes well, if it happens, I've got a promotional tour of Japan in mind.
And instead of ending this section on a low note, let's talk about the title cards, which just... blows my mind. Winter starts off the film and ends with the film, showing the change that has happened over the time gap. Then a transition into spring, which is showing them springing forward in their relationship.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Yeah, that was the point. Summer is shown to be a break from the rest of Hollywood and just a fun time with no consequences. And then we come to fall, the only title shown with no background, just simple text to show the fall of their relationship. The things that no one pays attention to in movies these days are taken with care and thought in this film. It shows how stories can be so much more than just that, a simple story. It can challenge your expectations. It can take you for a ride with everything that is on screen, not just to be fun, but to have a purpose. And that is why Damien Chazelle's direction is my favorite. Yeah, so I get it. This film on the surface can be a little simplistic. I know I said that in confusion, but that's just because I have a hard time saying this is a simple film. Because in my eyes, there is just so much more to behold in this movie. First, I think I should point out that this is a character piece, and if any of you guys have watched a video of mine, you know that I like talking.
You mean complaining, right?
Yeah, whatever. About character. And this movie doesn't just feature one protagonist, but two, and are the complete driving force for everything that happens in the movie. Now, I've already talked about color and cinematography, with how they relate to deepening the relationship between them, but what is actually going on story-wise? How does this film communicate its narrative as an actual film with dialogue and story structure?
Ah! Lunacy. Pure lunacy.
That's how. This film shows us from the first 10 seconds of seeing each protagonist, what their goals are and what their arc is going to be centering around in the film. Mia aspires to be an actress, and Sebastian wants to revive jazz. Both, you could say, have similar dreams. Mia being rejected for another audition yet again at the beginning of the story, and Sebastian getting fired from his job because he's not able to play passionately. All the while, both having close friends telling them that having someone to lean on is better than their dreams, but both ignore it. So how does their relationship come into play? It's how they're in the same places in their lives that bring them together, because they understand one another's goals and struggles to complete their said goal. This furthers Mia away from her Hollywood life and Sebastian into his, swapping their journeys, creating conflict between them, because they have already experienced where the other person is at in their life. Both are more passionate about each other's dreams, but what they don't realize is what the cost of that is, the sacrifice of what one another truly wants in their life. From the beginning, the story was not about their romantic journey. It was about their love for one another. Love that means giving up being together so they can accomplish their dreams. And it is all shown in these two shots. The disappointment that they aren't together is still there, but both understand the cost and remember the journey that they had. How both cared about what the other person did more than themselves, having both of the colors of their clothing being black, signifying that they have accomplished their dreams, being lit in blue, showing the love they still have for one another, playing the song that reminds them both of their journeys, showing a smile that means they will always still love each other and are truly happy with who they are and who they are with. A cathartic moment that means so much with no words spoken. And that is why the story of La La Land is my favorite. A favorite movie to me now means so much more than it used to. Once it was a movie that I just really enjoyed and I thought was almost perfect. But La La Land has shown me that a favorite film can be so much more than that. It can be something that you connect with personally. It can be something you aspire to be. It can reflect on your current life. It can mean something to you. I never realized that a film can mean something that words can't describe. I was silent after watching it because it had more than I had felt in a film before. It meant something they couldn't explain to people. How do you explain something that means something different to yourself than it does to anyone else? The truth is, you can't. You can tell them what you like about it, sure, but only you can understand what it means. So let me ask you this. What does your favorite movie mean to you? Someone in the